Hey, this is Scott, and today we're going to take a look at the ThinkTank Airport International version 3.0. If this is your first time to this channel, thanks for watching. Be sure to check out my other videos and subscribe if you want to see more in the future. So ThinkTank sent me this bag to use on my upcoming trip over to the States. For now, this review is going to be based on my using it the past few weeks for some photo shoots, as well as a small trip. But I will be making an updated version with long-term use and international travel experience, so be sure to keep an eye out for that. Before even getting into this, I just want to say that in my experience, ThinkTank bags have been the most true to their advertisement of any bags that I've tried. A lot of bags, you know, the videos or the promotions will make it look a little bit more useful or a little bit more practical than it may be, a little bit larger, what have you. But in my experience, every ThinkTank bag that I've used has been really true to the way that it's advertised. It works how it's supposed to work and it fits what it's supposed to fit. So if you're thinking about getting this style of bag, I would say don't hesitate, just get it and you won't be disappointed. So as you can see, it's quite large, and right now it's full, so it's also quite heavy, but it does fit under most airlines' carry-on size restrictions. So on one side and the top of this bag, there are some extremely well padded handles, which even if you have to carry this upstairs or something like that, it's very, very comfortable to do so. There are also thinner handles on the bottom of the bag as well as the other side. And this is basically just to help you to get it in and out of storage compartments. On the side of the bag with the thicker handle, there is a lock which is compatible with the TSA regulations. And basically you just snap the zippers into there and turn the dials. It's a combination lock, so you can set it, of course, to your own combination. And when you want to open it, you just press the buttons on the side and the zippers will pop out. There's a keyhole that allows the TSA to open the bag if they need to check it. On the top corner of this side, there's also one more thin seat belt-like handle that you can again use to help you to get it in and out of compartments, or I'm sure you could attach something to here if you really wanted to. Looking at the top, there's a clear slot where you can put a business card or identification card or anything, which is pretty much similar to any other kind of suitcase that you may use. And there's also a zipper where there's a steel cable and lock that you can use to lock this to a pole or something when you walk away from the bag. Or you can also use that lock to lock the zippers on the front compartment. Looking around to the other side, there's again a kind of seat belt like strap that you could use as a handle to help you get it in and out of storage, as well as an attachment point for some accessories that you can use that come with the bag to attach a tripod on the side of here. There's also a stretchy pocket that's not huge, but it could be useful. I have my rain cover shoved in here at the moment, so it doesn't take any space inside the bag. On the bottom of the bag, you will see, of course, the wheels, which are extremely, extremely smooth, makes pulling this bag absolutely no problem, even going up inclines, and of course the feet to help it balance. And also this bag is extremely well balanced, no matter how much weight you have inside of it. Along the bottom, corners, sides, and back of this bag, you also have some user replaceable covers, which help avoid bumps and scratches and damage to the actual bag itself. There are some nice patches in the top corners of the bag as well to help avoid some wear on the bag itself when you're laying it on the ground, perhaps. There's a metal badge on the back with a serial number, so you can register your bag with ThinkTank. In case it gets lost, you can help to track it. Finally, at the top, you'll see the telescoping handle, which works very smoothly, and the handle itself has a kind of rubbery finish to it, so it's very easy to grip. It's also easily accessible, unlike some of the earlier versions of this bag. On the front of the bag, there's a large stretchy pocket that at the moment is a little bit tight, but I imagine it will loosen up and break in over time. This could be useful to carry some stuff, but I imagine I would want to carry some flat stuff in here, especially if you have a computer in the front compartment. I wouldn't want to put anything that's too oddly shaped in case it gets hit on the front of the bag. I don't want it to really crush into the top of the computer too much. Before opening this front zipper, I just want to mention that the zippers and the pulls on this bag are really a step up from anything I've ever experienced with ThinkTank before, and that's saying a lot since they were already very good quality to begin with. So this front zipper will open up the compartment for the computer and tablet. It doesn't open incredibly wide, but more than wide enough to access what you need. There are some small pockets as usual with ThinkTank for pens and other small accessories, and there's also a small zippered pouch on the inside of the front flap. There's a space for a laptop, and I can fit my 15-inch MacBook Pro in there with no problem, as well as a space for a tablet. Outside of that, there's also just some free space in the pocket itself. When you open this flap, you'll see some big pockets on the inside, as is usual with most ThinkTank bags. They're made from a kind of clear plastic as usual, so you can see what's inside of them without having to dig around. The main part of this bag where you put your cameras is fairly deep, although there is a section in the middle which is a little bit shallower because it's cut out for the handle in the back. It's nice that they didn't cut away the entire back of the bag, so you can use the deeper areas for some longer lenses standing up, or really large lenses that may have really large lens hoods as well. Again, as is always true with ThinkTank, they give you a lot of these little dividers, and in this bag in particular, there's a lot of variety in what they give you. has a variety of sizes, including dividers that are long enough to run horizontally or vertically across the bag. Some are the standard material and others are covered in cloth, so you can attach them to each other and make some different arrangements inside the bag. Finally, at the top, you'll find a divider which has some cutaways, so you can put two camera bodies in here with lenses attached, or you can cover those openings up so you can put the bodies and lenses separately, which is usually recommended when you're traveling by airplane. Because of the rounded corners of this bag, as well as it being brand new and it needs to get broken in a little bit, I found it a little bit difficult at first to get the cameras with lenses attached in there. They didn't really want to sit straight, they wanted to be at a little bit of an angle, which was kind of awkward, but it can work though, and I know the bag will loosen up as it gets more broken in. Also, I did find that because of the cutaway for the wheels at the bottom corners, it's kind of at an angle and it's not perfectly straight, so those bottom two spots, they're a little bit wider at the top than they are at the bottom. Just be aware of that when you're putting lenses in there. So as far as an overview of this bag goes, that's pretty much it. As I mentioned, ThinkTank bags are pretty much what you see, what you get. You won't be disappointed. If you see this overview and it looks like it works for you, then I would just recommend you go out and get it. You will not be disappointed. It's made from really good materials, it's very rugged and easy to use, and everything's very well thought out as far as the design goes. I really can't think of anything that I would want to change about this, and that's not just me saying that, I really mean it. The only thing I haven't tested yet is how it fits on the airplane, so as long as that's okay, then there's really nothing to complain about. Whether it's for traveling or not, if you've ever used a rolling style bag, you'll know just how great it can be for carrying a large amount of heavy gear. It's really, really easy to use, even going uphill, downhill, or for long days, for long walks. It rolls along incredibly smoothly and you don't feel the weight in there. Add to that, it's extremely secure with all the locks and everything, and you can use it for international travel. It's TSA compatible with all those locks, so it's just an all-around great bag if you're carrying a lot of stuff. If you have any questions or comments, please leave it down below. I will be posting a video of what I have in this bag at the moment because I did just get back from a short trip, so if you want to see that, be sure to click the link on screen now or down in the description below. I'll post that when it's ready. If you liked this video or found it helpful, don't forget to give me a thumbs up, subscribe if you want to see more in the future, and as always, thanks for watching.